إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. It is so wonderful to see all of you here. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من يريد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين. A sign of goodness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to His servant that He grants him the comprehension, the fiqh, the understanding of the religion. Especially, ya ikhwa, janib al-ibadat, the side of rituals. هذا أمر, an issue that a lot of Muslims take for granted. They pray the way that they saw their parents praying. They fast the way which they saw their parents fasting. And so forth. Subhanallah, this always brings back the memory of the statement which always said to the prophets and the messengers, إِنَّا وَجَدْنَا آبَاءَنَا عَلَىٰ أُمَّةٍ وَإِنَّا عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. يعني, one of the things which used to stand in the way of the messengers, something which the scholars say, سُنَّةُ الْآبَاء. سُنَّةُ الْآبَاء, the way of the fathers, the way of the ancestors. This is what the people used to say to the messengers. Listen, we came and we found our parents doing this, and we will stick to the way of our parents, not to any other way. فبالعلم, with knowledge, الإنسان يخرج, a Muslim comes out of that circle. By the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have so far presented two lectures in our Fiqh al-Hajj, Fiqh al-Sawm this year. The first lecture we talk about Fadl al-Sawm wa Fadl siyami Ramadan, the virtues of fasting in general, and the virtues of fasting the month of Ramadan in particular. And last lecture we spoke about the two pillars of fasting, which is what? Intention and abstaining. And we spoke about some details there. The lecture tonight is very wealthy, rich. And I have to move with a fast pace in order to be able to cover it. Because we would like to finish in 5 lectures maximum, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Tonight, the lecture is titled Categories of People, Categories of Muslims Once It Comes to Fasting Ramadan. You will find that the people divide into 3 categories. The first one, the first category, those who have to fast. It is mandatory upon them to fast. Category number 2, those who cannot fast, it is haram for them to fast. Category number 3, in between. They could be exempt or they could be eligible to fast. It's in between the two. طيب. Once it comes to the first category, and you probably heard me saying this, but we'll go over it again quickly. Who has to fast?
We're talking about having to fast. Meaning what? It's what? You have no what? Choice. It is mandatory. You have to do it. الصيام واجب. Number one, every Muslim. Two, who is sane. Or first we should say, who reached the age of puberty. Baligh. Three, sane. He has the intellect in order. Four, healthy. Five, resident, not a traveler. Six, has to do with the sisters. They don't have their monthly cycle, nor the post petrum or whatever the word is, delivery bleeding. اللي هو النفاس. طيب. So this is category number one. Category number two, who cannot fast? The women who have their period or the post-delivery bleeding. It is haram for them to fast, in fact. They cannot fast. A woman is haram for her to fast while she is in that condition or in this condition. The condition of having a monthly period or she's still bleeding after delivery. And also, a person fasting would cause him death. Or it will deteriorate his health conditions. The doctor tells him you cannot fast. If you fast, you are endangering your health. But now we're talking about a doctor who understands that fasting is mandatory upon Muslims. It is not optional. And he gives him an honest assessment. There is no doubt about the fact that maybe he's trying to talk him out of fasting. If you trust this physician, this doctor, and he tells you that fasting would endanger your health, then you should not fast. The most problematic tonight, which is where we want to spend the majority of time, are those who are exempt, or they could fast. That would include the sick, the traveler, the elders, الشيخ والشيخة, the old man and the old woman, العجوز والعجوزة, والحبلى والمرضع, and the woman who is breastfeeding, and the woman who is pregnant. خلاص? So this is the agenda tonight. Make sense? Are you ready to go? Huh? Let's do the first category quickly. The first category should be simple, easy, straightforward. Fasting is mandatory upon every Muslim. Can the disbeliever fast? طب يعني your students of knowledge, I can see it in your faces, mashallah. سؤاله, هل الكافر مخاطب بفروع الشريعة كما هو مخاطب بأصولها? Is the disbeliever addressed with the branches of the religion like he is addressed with the principles? What are the principles of the religion? اللي هي ايه? اللي هي ايه? As a disbeliever, you should convey to him what? لا إله إلا الله. Is he addressed by the branch of the religion as well? Yes or no?
Yes.
طيب. Who said no? Raise your hand. All of you. طيب, what you want to say about this verse? ما سلككم في سقر? What brought you into Saqar? You know what Saqar is, right? Is one of the names of what? Of the hellfire, right? What did they say? قالوا لم نكو من المصلين. We did not pray. طب مش عجبك دي? You don't like this one? Look at this one. وويل للمشركين. Woo! Wail is a valley in hell. This is what the scholars of tafsir said about it. A valley in hell. Woo to the mushriks. شوف الذين لا يؤتون الزكاة. Those who do not pay the zakah. طب هو المشرك supposed to pay the zakah? طيب are you going to still say no? الكافر مخاطب. يعني الأمر حقيقة يعني for the للأمانة العلمية for يعني to convey the message honestly, the matter is a subject of debate. But you know why this is important? I brought it up in particular because I get asked this question all the time. You have brothers who run restaurants in America. صحيح؟ Muslim brothers. The question comes now. Can I keep my restaurant open during the day of Ramadan?
Not supposed to.
You know, that issue has to do with that issue. If the disbeliever is addressed with the branch of the religion, that means he's supposed to fast. That means you're not supposed to do what? Open your restaurant. بس طبعا our situation in the West is different. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم identified for us what we should do with the Christian and the Jews when we come to their land. Are you with me or no? Or am I on another planet?
Yes.
طيب. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said to معاذ بن جبل رضي الله عنه إنك تأتي قوما أهل كتاب. You will come to the people of the book. People who are living with in Yemen are Christian and Jews. Let be the first thing you call them to is what? And then he said ثم فإن. Then, so if you come to a majority Christian and Jews and you are a minority, they are required to hear what? La ilaha illallah. But if they are living in a Muslim state, they must do what? The branches. You're getting that? You got it? So if you own a restaurant in Egypt, for example, you should not open it during the course of the day, even for Christian and Jews, because they are required, because they know about La ilaha illallah. But if you come here and you have a restaurant and your clients are, the majority of them are Christian and Jews, they are supposed to hear what first? Then go ahead and serve them. But the question here, if the kafir fasts, what benefit does he get? Huh? Huh? طب إيه رأيك في أبو طالب who is a kafir and because of good things that he did and isn't the hellfire درجات؟ ما هو يقول لك الجنة درجات. الجنة is levels. How many? يا راجل يا راجل. Been teaching this at life. How many levels of Jannah?
Eight and seven heaven.
No, how many? I'm not asking how many gates to Jannah. I'm asking how many levels to Jannah. How many? 100 levels.
How many?
100. Eight gates, Fasih al-Din. Eight gates to Jannah. But 100 levels. You know the distance between each one is like here and the star that you see up there. Again, I would love to have time. And this is, I just want to stick to the curriculum. But let me say this quickly. Like Jannah is darajat, Jannah is levels, hell is what? Darakat. What do you call this? steps down, what do you call it? إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ Where are the hypocrites? That means the kafir is what? فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ So there are levels of hell. So the punishment can be decreased. صحيح ولا لا؟ So if he even so, it's not accepted. But Allah would decrease his punishment and he would place him in a place better than hell. Alhamdulillah. If you don't understand this, you know what? It's beside the point. Did you understand it, Jude? You did? Allahu Akbar.
So how many levels in hell?
Well, nothing mentioned. I don't know. The answer, I don't know. But we know it's darakat.
But it's gate are seven.
Gates to hell is seven. طيب. A question. What if a kafir, a disbeliever, accepts Islam during the course of the day of Ramadan? You're sitting like this. It's the month of Ramadan. It's already dhuhr time. Rajin, somebody who comes and says, Ya Muslimin, O Muslims, I would like to be like you. It is already Ramadan. All you have to do, Ya Akhi, is say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Tayyib, he has been eating and drinking all morning. You tell him, from now you fast until the end of the day. And you don't have to make this day up. Got it?
Yes.
So he's going to end up fasting from the time he initiates his Islam. And he doesn't have to make up this day. Tayyib. Fasting is mandatory upon every Muslim. Two, عاقل, sanity,
sane.
That takes the insane out. طيب, إيه الدليل? What is the evidence regarding sanity? حديث عائشة رضي الله عنها والحديث في سنن الترمذي والنسائي وأبي داود. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم says, رفع القلم عن ثلاثة. The pen of taklif, the angels who write your hasanat and your sayyat, do not write the hasanat, the good deeds, or the sayyat, the bad deeds of that person. There is a saying that they write the good deeds, but at least they do not write the bad deeds of the following three people. Number one, an-na'imu hatta yastayqidh. The one who is asleep until he wakes up. Two, وَالصَّبِيُّ حَتَّى يَحْتَلِمُ And the young boy and girl who are under the age of puberty until they experience puberty, and we'll tell you how. Three, وَالْمَجْنُونُ حَتَّى يَعْقِلُ وَفِي رِوَايَةٍ وَالْمَعْتُوهُ حَتَّى يَعْقِلُ And the insane until he reaches or regains his sanity again. Why, ya ikhwa? Why? What is the wisdom? The insane person is not eligible to fast.
He does not want to do
it. Know what? Beautiful. Ahsant. لأن احنا قلنا the pillar of fasting, the main pillar of fasting is what? The intention. المجنون, the one who is insane, he does things without what? ما يعرف. He does things without an intention out there. طب, a question. What if someone who's insane, Majnoon, fasts? What if he decides to fast? Go ahead and fast. And we encourage him. And we tell him, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ مَنْ أَحْسَنَ عَمَلًا Allah will never waste your reward. Go ahead and fast. طيب. A related question to intellect and mind. لأن العقل يا إخوة, the brain is مدار التكليف في الإسلام. العقل, having the brain is what makes you eligible to fulfill your obligations. What if a sane person, like you and me, during the course of the day, let's not say that became insane, but they lost their conscience. They became what? Unconscious for one reason. Somebody hit them in the head or something and they became what? Not paying attention to what they're doing and they're walking around. Maybe for an hour and two and they eat and they drink and they are supposed to be fasting. What is the ruling? And then after an hour, they regain their
conscious again. What is the rule? Is the day void? No, it is not. No, it is not. طيب.
Number three. So every Muslim who is what? Sane. Three. Baligh.
Reach the age of puberty. What is the evidence? The hadith I just quoted, right? The hadith mentioned three. One of them, and then boy until he reaches what? The age of puberty. طيب. Can our children who have not reached the age of puberty fast?
Yes.
Actually, it is highly recommended that they should fast. As a matter of fact, in the story of fasting the day of Ashura, a female companion whose name is Rubayya bint Mu'awwidh says, وَكُنَّا نَصُومُ, and we used to fast Ashura, وَنُصَوِّمُ صُبْيَانَنَا, and we used to ask our little ones to fast as well. وَكُنَّا نَصْنَعُ لَهُمُ اللُّعْبَةَ مِنَ الْعِهْمِ, and we used to make toys for them made out of wool, incentive, yeah. That you tell your child, listen, if you fast, I will give you this, I will give you that, I will give. So you should actually, the sunnah, that you should give them what? A toy, a gift, as a reward, if they do fast. فالسنه الحديث في البخاري قصه صوم عاشوراء في صحيح الامام البخاري طيب the parents do get a reward for that.
Yes.
The parents do get a reward for training their children to fast. The question is, when should I start with my children? We always use the age of the salah as for the rest of the pillars, train them. But now, if he cannot make it the whole day, start with a half day, start with a quarter of a day, and so forth, until they get in the fashion. Now, the question here is, how do we know that a boy or a girl reached the age of puberty? Four signs. Three, and then the criterion is number four. Number one, the growth of hair in private areas. شعر العانة. The hair under the armpit and in the private area down there. The fact that they have hair. Number two, having wet dreams. That's another sign. Three, for the sisters, for the women, experiencing their menses. Now, if you do not see those three signs, then the age of 15 is the final cut. If they reach the age of 15, خلاص, they have reached the age of puberty. طيب, what if a young boy reaches the age of puberty during the day of Ramadan and he is not fasting? What should he do? قيس على الكافر. He begins fasting from the time he reached the age of puberty and he doesn't have to make up this day. So fasting is mandatory upon every Muslim. Two.
Sane.
Three. Huh? بالغ. Puberty. Number four. صحيح. Healthy. طبعا إن شاء الله we will explain this with the third category in details regarding sickness. But in general, the evidence that the sick individual does not have to fast, قول الله تعالى, the statement of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, فمن كان منكم مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر. If you are sick or a traveler, then you can make up the days later on. But we will learn, once we talk about sickness, that not every sickness should give you that license. Also, the traveler, inshallah, we will talk about it with the third category. So, inshallah, we will address it in the third category. Number six, the women being clear from cycle and menses, inshallah, we will talk about it in the second category. So fasting, again, let me repeat this before we move to the second category quickly. Fasting is mandatory upon every Muslim
who is sane, who is baligh, reach the age of puberty, who is healthy, who is resident, not a traveler. And once it comes to the sisters, she is clear from her menses and the post-delivery bleeding. Category number two, whatever we did not explain will be explained later on with the rest of the categories. Category number two, who cannot fast? We mentioned the first time, al-ha'id wal-nufasa, the women who are on their cycle, and also the women who are still experiencing the post-delivery bleeding. Shuf, ajma' al-ulama, there is a consensus amongst the scholars that the woman who is menstruating and the woman who is still bleeding post her delivery, لا يصح صومهما, their fasting is invalid, ولا يجب عليهما الصوم, and fasting is not mandatory upon them, بل يحرم عليهما, rather it is haram, unlawful for them to fast, and they must make up the days after they are clear from their period or the post-delivery bleeding. What are the evidence for this? Evidence? Number one, Hadith Aisha, Umm al-Mu'mineen, radiyallahu anha, fi sahih al-Imam Muslim, Aisha says, kunna nahidu ala ahdi Rasulillah, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, we used to have our monthly cycle during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, فَنُؤْمَرُ بِقَضَاءِ الصَّوْمِ وَلَا نُؤْمَرُ بِقَضَاءِ الصَّلَاةِ, and we used to be commanded to make up the days which we missed from Ramadan, but we do not make up the days of the Salah which we missed during our what? Our prayer. Women, by the way, who have their cycle, they do not have to pray the days. They get a break from the Salah. Yani, subhanallah, yani, Allah give them a break every month. Huh? Ya ikhwa, you really have to look at it this way. Yani, I'll never forget this brother one day when I, you know, one day we were talking about traveling and how much he loves traveling. And I said, why do you love traveling? You know what he said? Because I shorten the Salah, it feels good. You know, he loves traveling because he shortens the Salah. As long as you're not traveling for the purpose of what? تحايل على الأمر, ده موضوع تاني. But if you happen to travel, that's a license. افرح بهذا يعني. قل بفضل الله وبرحمته فبذلك فليفرحوا. This is a mercy of Allah upon the women. The second evidence is Hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri رضي الله عنه في صحيح البخاري, الحديث المعروف, the famous hadith that the women have a deficit in their iman, a deficit, نقصان في الدين, نقصان في الدين. And then later on the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم explains why their iman drops. أليس إذا حاضت, when she is menstruating, when she has her period, لم تصلي ولم تصم, she doesn't fast nor she does pray, فهذا عفوا فذلك نقصان دينها. This is what causes her iman to do what? To drop. That is why, ya ikhwa, when your spouses, your wives having the period, they are more what? Fighting spirit. Be careful. Handled with care during the period. Why? Because the iman is dropping. And when you have iman, you know, you handle people better. Try it. When your level of faith is up there, people can just push you around and you're smiling. Nothing wrong with you. But when your iman is weak, you want to pull a fight with everybody. The same exact thing with the women. During her cycle, she is more into what? Arguing and fighting, handle with kids. Now they have to make up the days after what? After they are clear from the period. طيب. Matters related to the monthly cycle and
the post-delivery bleeding. إذا طهرت المرأة, a woman who had her cycle in Ramadan, now during the course of the day, her cycle stopped. Let's say 1 o'clock, her period what? Stop. What should she do? Huh? تأكل. نعم. Beside the ghusl, regarding eating and drink, it is permissible for her to eat and drink until the day is over. طبعا الموضوع ده في there is a debate between الأحناف, الإمام أبي حنيفة and his school, and the rest of the imams. الإمام أبي حنيفة يعني يرى, he says, or his school, they say that she should abstain. But there is no evidence for this. Rather, في مصنف ابن أبي شيبة, عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه made a beautiful statement, and he said, من أكل في أول النهار فليأكل في آخر. If you eat at the beginning of the day, then there is no harm, what? Because you already came up with something which invalidate your fasting. This is a different case.
What is the question?
He's asking whether this opposes the person who took the shahada, the non-Muslim who became a Muslim. You see, this is a different case. We're talking about she been a Muslim, even so she was in her period, but she was exempt from fasting because of her period. Now it happened that she cleared her period in the middle of the day. Now what should she do? That's the question. It's different. طيب, is it permissible for women to take medicine in order to stop their period during the month of Ramadan in order to fast the 30 days? Man, you are a quickie jurist. Take it easy with fiqh. Relax. You know fiqh? You know when you study fiqh, you relax a little bit with the religion. Different to the aqidi. You know, the fiqh relaxes you. You know, it really shows you the beauty of the of Islam, the beauty of the religion of Islam. لأن فهم النصوص يا إخوة, understanding the text takes a lot of... طيب, let me ask you, you said no. What if she takes the medication and she fasts these days? Is her fasting valid? Do you understand my question now? She's supposed to have 7 days period. She decided to take medication. The brother said no for the medication. But let's assume that she went ahead and took the medication. She's going to end up fasting her period. Is her fasting valid, or she has to make up these days?
If she's not bleeding, it is valid.
شوف الكلام. ما هو it's all connected. It's like a spider net. You go into this one, come back. This one, what are you going to do with this one? We say, شوف هذه, لا ننصح بذلك. As a jurist, you say, we don't advise to do this. فإن النساء, because the women, على عهد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, at the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, were more righteous than the women now. And they never done this. شوف. فهم عن عبد الله, فهم إيه الكلام؟ إن أنت إيه, you try to convince them, because there are people who believe that I shouldn't miss one day from Ramadan. There are sisters who have aqidah regarding this issue. Now try to understand, try to speak, address their hearts. Listen, عائشة لما حاضت رضي الله عنها في الحج, when عائشة had her period during حج, and she was crying, right? What did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say to her? Anybody knows? This is something which Allah prescribed upon you, daughters of Adam. Daughters of Adam alayhi salam. There is nothing wrong with it. هذا شيء افترضه الله عليكم يا بنات آدم. There is nothing wrong with it. That you have your period and you eat and drink while people are fasting. Because this is the sharia. This is the deen. We say to the sisters, they should not do it. But if the sister does it,
and she fasts, يُجْزِئُهَا الصَّوْمُ, her fasting is valid. هذا هو الكلام. ولكن لننصح. And we say, if the doctor informs you that this endangers your health, that's another issue now. If you receive a doctor advice that he cannot do this because this will expose your health to danger, then we tell her, يَا أُخْتِ يَحْرُمْ عَلَيْكِ هَذَا, you cannot do this. This is unlawful for you to do this. طبعا يا إخوة, there is something that we call الاستحاضة. يعني الاستحاضة, women normally do have a certain number of days for their period. She knows 6 days. طيب, she keeps having 6 days, 6 days. Let's imagine the month of Ramadan, she ended up having 10 days. Then we tell her the 6 days is your period, and the 4 days, even so you still have blood, but yet you still can have fast, because this is called what? Istihada, is not hayd. Also women who have delivered and they reach 40 days, and they are still bleeding after the 40 days, and it is Ramadan, we tell her, go ahead and fast, this is istihada. She also can pray, provided that she makes wudu for each salah after the time of the salah enters, after the adhan, for each salah. طيب. Are you with me? خلاص, she begins fasting. هو الاستحاضة بالنسبة للنفاس, 40 days is the time. طيب. إذا حاضت المرأة قبل غروب الشمس. Imagine this scenario, إخوة. A woman who ends up having her period 5 minutes before the sunset. Five minutes before the sunset. Does she have to make up this day? Absolutely. يرحمكم الله. Absolutely. She has to make up this day, provided, even if she doesn't eat or drink. Now. Well, different ibadah, yes. Absolutely. They can do dhikr, dua, istighfar. Absolutely. Yeah. Now. So, now even if she doesn't eat and drink, let's say she saw the blood 5 minutes before the sunset. She did not eat nor drink. The day is already what? Nullified. Alhamdulillah. But does she get a reward for that? Absolutely. Remember, fasting in general, the reward is with who? With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna Allah. يعني, we don't want the sister to feel bad about this, as if it's a game or something. No, it is not a game. Guess what? This could يعني, tip your scale in the day of resurrection. You never know. Yeah, she has to make up these days. She has to make up this day. But ya ikhwa, we need to pay attention to something here, that she sees the blood. Not she experiences the pains of the period. Some women are like this. Yani, it's all in the books of fiqh, okay? I don't know about this. I just read about them. All right? Some sisters, before their period, maybe 2, 3, 4 hours, they start having what? Physical pain. No, we're not talking about the pain, dear sisters. We're talking about you seeing the blood. This is the variable. طيب. The second type, which cannot fast, are those fasting will endanger their health, and this will be in the sickness side of things. So let's move to category number 3 now. Are we doing okay? Huh? I can't see the time there. Do we have what? We're doing good with the time?
9:38.
Okay. MashaAllah. طيب. Category number 3. Muslims who are exempt from fasting, or they could fast. That category includes the sick, the traveler, the elder, male, female, and the pregnant and the breastfeeding. Let's deal with the sickness. المرض. What is the definition of sickness? هو كل ما خرج به الإنسان عن حد الصحة من علة. Now, there is a consensus amongst the jurists that it is permissible for anyone who is sick to break his fast during the month of Ramadan. The evidence, قول الله تعالى, the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala في سورة البقرة, فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ مَرِيضًا أَوْ عَلَى سَفَرٍ فَعِدَّةٌ مِنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ. If you are sick or a traveler, then you can make up the days later on. And sickness, pay very much attention to this now, fall into three types. مرض لا يتأثر بالصوم. A sickness which does not get affected at all by fasting. Like a little headache, running nose, pain in the gum. Don't tell me that I'm having some pains in my gum and so I'm going to break my fast. لا. يعني الصوم لا يؤثر فيه. Fasting does not affect it. It is not permissible for this person to break his fast. The second type of sickness, مرض, a sickness, يشق عليه الصوم ولا يضره. يعني fasting would add hardship to him, but it does not endanger his life. يعني كان in the middle. يعني he would hardly have a hard time. It is permissible for him to break his fast if he wants to. That is type number two. Type number three, مرض يشق عليه الصوم ويضره ويعرضه للموت. A type of sickness which fasting could endanger, deteriorate his health, and causes him to die. Example, يا إخوة اللي هم الإيه درجات معينة من مرض السكري, the diabetes. There are brothers who have diabetes. Impossible for them to certain levels of it. يعني. Diabetes is different levels. الإخوة اللي نسأل الله أن يشفي جميع المرضى المسلمين يا رب العالمين. الإخوة اللي عندهم الكلى بيحتاج إنه يغسل و... يعني ف we have to look at the sickness. And normally the statement of a doctor, the advice of a physician would again serve the cause here, provided that again you have educated this physician about your religion, that this is a pillar of Islam. You know, inform him, listen, I'm not asking for a doctor notice here. You know, they are very good with writing doctor notices. You know, for them is a customer service. صحيح ولا لا? Isn't that correct? Make sure that you educate, and this is again a moment of da'wah. Make sure that you educate your physician about what? About fasting and what is fasting is all about. طيب. A person who broke his fast because of a sickness, what should he do? Case number one, his sickness is curable. Is that a correct English, curable? Huh? No? Can be cured? What about that? Is that correct? Okay. Can be cured. Meaning he can get better afterwards. This person has to wait and make up the days. His sickness, case number two, his sickness is terminal. No chance. The doctor tells him, you're going to have it. This person feeds for each day one miskin. Fahimtu ya ikhwa? You understand? One meal. So for 29 or 30 days, he ends up feeding what? One person, 30 meals, or 30 persons, one meal. Masakin. And again, ya ikhwa, we're going to talk about ahkam al-fidya. We're going to talk about al-fidya, that it's not meant by it that you go and sign your name out there to la. إطعام مساكين. يا إخوة, there is a difference between offering breakfast to a fasting person and you feeding masakin as a ransom for your fasting. It must go to masakin. Not everybody who comes to the masjid to break his fast is miskin. The reward is tremendous, so we don't want to belittle that. طيب. Let's talk about some sickness-related issues quickly. رجل مريض بمرض مزمن. Here is a good scenario right here. رجل مريض مرض مزمن. الدكتور قال له ما فيش إيه. The doctor told him no what, no cure. سبحان الله. Allah سبحانه وتعالى given him the cure. ما هو who cures. وإذا مرضت فهو يشفين سبحانه وتعالى. But now, let's say that he has been sick for 10 years. So he did not fast 10 Ramadan. And he ended up feeding for these 10 Ramadan. You understanding? Now he became bitter. What should he do? Continue what? He just needs to start fasting the Ramadan to come. خلاص. And if he misses days, then he makes it up. No more what? Ransom. But should he go back and re-fast the days that he ransomed for? No, he should not. طيب. Someone who got sick during the month of Ramadan. نسأل الله أن يشفي جميع مرضى المسلمين يا رب العالمين. And he did not, let's say the last 15 days of the month, he started being ill. And he carried on being sick 2 months after Ramadan. This is all hypothetical. He missed 15 days in Ramadan. Then he died. Then he died. 2 months after Ramadan. He never got better. Now we know that your children can fast for you the mandatory fast. Should they do that? Should they fast the 15 days for him? No. He's never been eligible to fast. Never been eligible to fast. Because he has been what? But here is another scenario. He got better after Ramadan. He still owed the 15 days. And then he kind of slacked, you know, and, you know, he said, I'm going to make it up. Let me take my time. Maybe wait until the winter comes. And then he got sick again and he died. Should his children fast for him? Yes. Yes. The first, no, because he's never been eligible. But the second one, he became what? Eligible to make up the difference. You're getting that? طيب. This is all the يعني, kind of weird scenarios. طيب. Number two, the traveler. يا إخوة, a word of advice. The issue of the distance. Nothing in the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says 50 miles, 60 miles, 80 miles. Nothing. Nothing. All of these numbers are ijtihadat fuqaha. Jurists came up with it to help their communities. But you become a traveler based on what is customary. I always use this example. If I'm sitting right now and telling you, brothers, I'm traveling, inshallah, to Centennial tonight. What do you think about that? Traveling? Centennial? Sheikh, say I'm going to Centennial. You see that? But if I tell you that I'm traveling to Cheyenne. Cheyenne is in Cheyenne, Wyoming. Would that make sense to you? Yes. So, what is customary? But don't say 50, 60, 80, or so forth. طيب.
Is it too far prayer as well?
Yeah, the distance for salah too. What is the ruling regarding fasting while you are a traveler? يباح للمسافر. It is permissible. Look at this now. It is permissible for the traveler to break his fast. And this is, by the way, a little bit different to the sick. The sick, we were a little bit picky. We said not every what? Not a gum pain, not some running nose, you should break your fast. I'm telling you, fasting, just being a fasting, a traveler, just being a traveler, you have a license. Regardless whether it is comfortable, air conditioning, you have a license. It's a little bit different. مع السفر. لعموم قول الله تعالى فمن كان منكم مريضا أو على سفر. بالعكس انت عندك ابن حزم رحمه الله له رأي عجيب في الموضوع ده. ابن حزم يقول لك if you are a traveler and you're fast and you fast, your fasting is invalid. له رأي عجيب. Your fasting is invalid. لأن الله said what? فعدة من أيام أخر. If you are a traveler, then you must fast these days in what? In other days, not these days. طبعا رأي يعني مردود. الجمهور رأيهم نعم. اصبر كده وكل الكلام ده لو ما جابش نتيجة معاك. All these scenarios which I'm going to come up with, if it doesn't answer your question, then I will go to your case. طيب. Now the question here, is it permissible for someone who is traveling and his travel is comfortable to break his fast? Absolutely. He can break his fast. Is it permissible for him to fast? Absolutely, he can fast. Is his fasting valid? Absolutely, it is valid. وَيُجْزِئُهُ. What is the evidence for the fact that your fasting is valid while you are traveling? Which again would refute the view of Ibn Hazm. Hadith Aisha radiallahu anha في البخاري ومسلم. A sahabi ikhwa whose name is Hamza Ibn Amr al-Aslami radiallahu anha. He used to love fasting. He came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he asked him, Ya Rasul Allah, O Messenger of Allah, أَأَصُومُ فِي السَّفَرِ. Should I fast while I am traveling? الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم answered him by saying, إِن شِئْتَ فَصُمْ وَإِن شِئْتَ فَأَفْطِرْ. If you want fast, if you want, break your fast. It's up to you. يعني I'm going to say this why I think the issue, الموضوع له علاقة بالإمكانية الذاتية, يعني the individual what capacity. شوف في صحيح الإمام مسلم أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه وجابر بن عبد الله, they both narrate this hadith. Look at this. سافرنا مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. We used to travel with the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. فيصوم الصائم ويفطر المفطر ولا يعيب بعضنا على بعض. And some of us would be fasting and some of us would be breakfasting. Some of us utilizing the license and some of us are fasting. And nobody says, oh, look at him, he's breaking his fast. Because they have what? A level of understanding. طيب. Now the question comes, which is better? Should I fast while I'm a traveler? Or should I break fast? What should I do? Which is better? جماهير الصحابة, the consensus amongst the companions, and الأئمة الأربعة والتابعين, our righteous predecessors, and the four imams. And whatever I'm going to say right now is the statement which was made by Umar ibn Abdul Aziz رضي الله عنه رحمه الله, or we could say رضي الله عنه for making dua for him. What did he say? أيسرهما أفضلهما. You're asking, I'm a traveler, should I fast or not? Whatever is easier on you, do it. Is fasting easier on you? Do it. Break fasting is easier on you? Do it. Yani, to expound on the issue a little bit, yani, to detail, there are three cases. Once it comes to traveling, fasting would endanger your health, would actually cause you a lot of hardship, that you actually may end up dying because of fasting. At this stage, we say to that person, it is haram to fast. وعنّا قصة حديث جابر بن عبد الله رضي الله عنهما في البخاري ومسلم. كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في سفر. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was traveling. فرأى زحاما شديدا. He saw a lot of people gathering. And he saw in the middle of them somebody laying down, fainted. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ما هذا؟ What is wrong with him? قالوا يا رسول الله صائم. O Messenger of Allah, he is fasting. Until he what? He is fasting until he what? Fainted. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, ليس من البر الصوم في السفر. It is not a sign of righteousness and piety that you fast while you're traveling. But again, we should confine this to what? To what? To this condition, that you endanger your health, endanger your life. ورد يا إخوة في صحيح الإمام مسلم رواية جابر بن عبد الله وعند البخاري من حديث عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عن الجميع. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was traveling the year of فتح مكة, the victory of Mecca. From Medina, Fath Mecca, by the way, the victory of Mecca happened in Ramadan. A lot of these hadith are coming from this. Because the Prophet was traveling with his Sahaba. طيب. One of these days, they arrived a place called Kira al-Ghamim, a location. And it was extremely, extremely hot. يعني, out of this world. شوف, out of the mercy of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he called upon a drink. دَعَى بِشَرَاب. He asked them, bring me a drink of water. And he stood like this in front of his Sahaba, like this, holding the drink like this. And he took a drink. فَشَرِب. When he saw that the condition is really hard, he took a drink. Later on, he was told, O Messenger of Allah, some of the companions carried on fasting. They did not break their fast. You know what he said? أولئك العصاة. أولئك العصاة. Those are the disobedient. Those are the disobedient. لأن الأسوة, your example is doing it. وأنت تنأى عنها, then there is something wrong with you. So this is case number one. When travel brings what? Extreme hardship. Case number two, pay very much attention to this. Traveling would limit you, would, you know, take away some of your goodness. That, you know, you're not as active as possible, that you can do other good things. And I will narrate this hadith to you, and you will understand what I'm trying to say. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, fi sahih al-Imam Muslim, he says, كنا مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في السفر. We were traveling with the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. فمنا الصائم ومنا المفطر. Some of us are fasting and some of us are breaking their fast. قال, he said, فنزلنا منزلا في يوم حار. We ended up camping in one of the locations. The day was extremely hot. What happened? As soon as they stopped for camping, فسقط الصوان. Those who are fasting did what? You know, like, they are tired. Look now. وَقَامَ الْمُفْطِرُونَ. And those who broke their fast, they stood up. فَضَرَبُوا الْأَبْنِيَةِ. They prepared the tents for the camp. And they brought the water for the animals. They what? They did all the work to prepare what? The overnighting. You know what the Prophet ﷺ said? ذَهَبَ الْمُفْطِرُونَ الْيَوْمَ بِالْأَجْرِ. شوف الفقه. لأنه إيه أتى بخير تاني خالص دفع غيره. Those who broke their fast today got the best reward. Why? Because they ended up what? Benefiting what? Serving what? Others. Serving the ummah. شايف؟ It becomes disliked when you're traveling and fasting with limit that your goodness, that you eat, you become more beneficial to other people, that you benefit other people. You understood this? طيب. Case number three, اللي هو إيه؟ Fasting doesn't bring any burden upon you. لا يعوق على فعل الخير. Then we say, وأن تصوموا خير لكم. It's better that you fast. And we mentioned more than one evidence for this. الصحابي who asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, should I fast while I'm traveling? He said to him, إن شئت فصم. If you want fast and if you want break your fast. We say that also it is recommended that you should fast براءة للذمة. Because الأصل إنك إيه يعني that you get done with Ramadan. Always it's easier when you fast when people are fasting. Provided that fasting does not bring what? Any hardship. طيب. Did we answer your case or not yet? Alhamdulillah. طيب. Traveling related issues, quickly now. We have to speed up a little bit. When it is permissible for that traveler to break his fast? Well, two assumptions. Assumption number one, that Fajr comes while you are traveling, then there is no issue. You don't have to worry about it. You can just go ahead and eat. Or you started traveling before Fajr, then we don't have an issue. You just carry on eating, you break your fast. The issue is when the travel is initiated after Fajr. That brings a lot of questions. Question number one. Technically, if your travel would begin after Fajr, in your case at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. 3:45 in the afternoon. Now, technically, before Fajr, you must have intended to do what? To fast. Now comes in the question, can you break your fast? Abu Hanifa said no, rahimahullah. Abu Hanifa wa Malik wa Shafi'i wa Ruwayah an Ahmad. They are not supposed to break their fast. Why? Because the intention is already what? The view of the normally we look at the majority. Subhanallah, the majority say no, you cannot. But few scholars said yes, you can. Ishaq ibn Rahaway, wal Hasan al Basri, very few. And you know they happen to have the evidence. And I quoted the evidence a minute ago. Anybody remember what the evidence? What evidence can be used for this? What evidence? Then Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم raised the drink and he had a drink. This was in Ramadan. And he already had the intention right here. Yes, if you happen to travel, number one, If your travel happens during the course of the day, you cannot say, I'm traveling tomorrow, therefore I'm not going to have the intention to fast. No, you must have the intention to fast. You must have the intention to fast. Now, when you become a traveler, then you could break your fast based on that hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam raised the drink up. He was fasting. He already formulated the intention. So the evidence is with them. طيب. طيب. Should you eat before you leave your house? Or when you become let's say that you're traveling. صحيح؟ Huh? You already intended to fast. During the course of the day, you kept fasting until 2 o'clock. Your flight is at 3:45. Now, should you eat before you leave your house or you wait until you leave the city? Subhanallah, this is the view of the consensus. Anas did this. ورد في سنن الترمذي والأثر صحيح. That Anas prepared his camel and he's about to travel and he called upon water and he ate. But the condition here that you must be already what? Dressed, ready to leave. But I'm telling you, yani even so, this is the view of the consensus. But yet this view is not technical at this time. You know why? Because you don't control the travel. You see, in the past, you used to have your camel. Sahih? But right now, you go to the airport. Ladies and gentlemen, flight to Minneapolis, St. Paul has been canceled. Go back home. What should you do? Yani, technically, yeah. This is one scenario. But if you have your car too, that would apply. But in some cases, like airplanes, like airports, it's not technical. That's where you need to use what? Your fiqh, your understanding of the situation. طيب. Now.
If I make my intention before the
Now, we talked about this once. We spoke about the intention last lecture. Al-amr, the matter is debatable amongst the jurists. Some of them said one intention is sufficient for the whole month, and the rest, Abi Hanifa and Shafi'i, they said no. One intention is needed for each day. فالأحوط أن تنوي لكل يوم. نعم. طيب. Okay. Is it permissible? Okay. Now, somebody who arrived from traveling, he's a traveler, here is a scenario. He came home, he became a resident. In the middle of the day of Ramadan, he's been eating the whole morning. What should he do? Carry on eating until and start fasting what? From tomorrow. But again, the view of Abi Hanifa and his ashab, his students, they say he has to abstain the rest of the day, and they base this in qiyasan, using analogy ala yawm al-shak, that when you find out the day of shak, yani. طيب, it is not permissible for a Muslim to trick in order to break his fast. He doesn't feel like fasting, he gets in the car, and says, what? I'm going to just drive to Chicago. ما ينفع. هذا احتيال على الشر. You shouldn't do it. Brothers who drive trucks or taxi drivers. Of course, taxi drivers, they are not travelers because they are what? They are going in circles. But brothers who travel across state with trucks, they have a license to break their fast. They have a license to break their fast. Here is a scenario. You come back home, You were a traveler. I mean, this is a weird scenario. You were a traveler and you broke your fast because you were a traveler. Your wife happened to have her period and she ended up clear from her period when you arrived home. Can you have a relationship with her? You can. It is permissible. Without kafar. طيب. Quickly, ikhwa. I can hear the adhan. Can we hang in there 5 minutes? We'll make it up quickly. Inshallah. Number three, the elder man and woman. Ajma' al-ulama, the jurist, have consensus that the old man and the old woman who are incapable, al-ajizina an al-sawm, who are unable to fast, it is permissible for them to break their fast. But again, not every old man, not every old woman. They must come with the restriction that they are unable to fast. Now, mashallah. Now, what should they do? They should make up these days by feeding one miskeen for each day. طيب, we come to the final case, final scenario. Ya ikhwa, the pregnant and the breastfeeding. الحبلى والمرضع. هذه مسألة هامة جدا. This issue is so important. And it is good that we have a lot of people who become aware of this issue. Why? Because there are a lot of views regarding it. Number one, there is no differing amongst the jurists that women who are pregnant and they cannot fast because it's unhealthy for them or unhealthy for their children, and women who are breastfeeding and they cannot fast because the flow of milk will be decreased, the nutrition in the milk will be decreased, that they have a license to break their fast. There is no question about this. حُبْلَ وَالْمُرْضِعِ, as long as they have these reasons, the doctor tells her, Ya أختي, you're pregnant, you cannot fast, because this will endanger your health or endanger the health of the baby, she has a license to break her fast. Or the sister who's breastfeeding, the doctor tells her, listen, the flow of your milk will be decreased. Or there are certain nutritions that you must eat for in order to be out there in the milk. If you fast, you will deprive your child from it. No question, no differing that the jurists have consensus that these sisters, they have a license to break their fast. هذا بالإجماع. الدليل.
How about the mothers who don't breastfeed their children?
That's another issue. We're talking about those who breastfeeding. Now, الدليل, the evidence, حديث أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه في سنن أبي داود. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم called Abu Anas one day and he said to him, Udnu, come closer to me. And then he said to him, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَضَعَ عَنِ الْمُسَافِرِ شَطْرَ الصَّلَاةِ وَعَنِ الْمُسَافِرِ وَالْحُبْلَى وَالْمُرْضِعَ الصَّوْمِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has pardoned the person who is traveling half of the salah, meaning he shortens, and he also has pardoned the pregnant, the breastfeeding, and the traveler from fasting. The differing here regarding what should they do. Ashhar al-Aqwal, the most famous views are three. Inshallah, we'll finish with this. We'll finish the lecture with this, inshallah. Al-Qawl al-Awwal, the first view, al-Qadha wal-It'am, that they must make up the days and also feed. وهذا قول المالكية والشافعية. الإمام مالك والإمام الشافعي. ولكن فصلوا. But they detailed. They said, if she broke her fast for fear of her health because of her, then she makes up the days. But if she broke her fast because of her baby, whether in the womb or whether being breastfed, then she makes up the days and she feeds both. We got that? The second opinion, الأوزاعي, أبي حنيفة والأوزاعي والثوري سفيان وأبو ثور وأبو عبيد وأصحابهم. شوف, she only makes up the days. She only, and this is, by the way, the most common view, that she makes up the days. Why? قاسوا على الحديث. شوف الحديث يقول لك إيه. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم says, and Allah pardoned the traveler, and the pregnant, and the breastfeeding from fasting. Now what the traveler has to do? What? Then those two has to do the same. شايف انت, look how they took it out, how they استدلوا بالحكم. قال ما هم جنب بعض. They were mentioned together. Then the same thing happens to them. Just اجتهاد. Here is another view which is interesting. And I'm telling this view is very practical, and I'll show you how. And this is the view of Abdullah ibn Abbas, Abdullah ibn Umar, ومذهب إسحاق ابن راهوي, والشيخ الألباني رحمه الله chose this opinion. What? That they only have to feed. الفدية فقط. And there is a very interesting scenario that really shows you that it's very applicable. Ya ikhwa, this matter is related to birth control. Are we allowed to use birth control? The answer is no. Only in two cases. If there is danger on the health of the mother, or if it is within the two years of breastfeeding, you can do that. You can prevent birth during the 2 years of breastfeeding. وَالْوَالِدَاتُ يُرْضِعْنَ أَوْلَادَهُنَّ حَوْلَيْنِ كَامِلًا. Apart from that, no. Now let's say that a Muslim woman who's going to stick to that, she want to have babies, so the Prophet ﷺ would be happy in the day of resurrection because of our numbers. Imagine this. She gets pregnant. At least there is one Ramadan. She delivers and breastfeeds for 2 years. How many? Three. Then she gets pregnant again. And then she breastfeeds. Then she gets pregnant again. Then she breastfeeds. Then she gets pregnant again. Let's say she's going to have 10 babies. How many Ramadan are those?
Many.
Impossible to make up the days. So if the sister of that category, that view, but if the sister is going to fear the figure, and or the brother is afraid he's going to have babies because he may not have enough money, or then we tell him, make up the days and feed and so forth. So we could alternate between these three views. But the most common of them is Ra'i Abi Hanifa, which is the second one. And the last view, which would apply to certain sisters who always get pregnant and breastfeed and so forth. طبعاً, very quickly, the evidence for the third view, الإمام الطبراني, عفواً, ابن جرير الطبري, وصححه الألباني وقال إسناده صحيح على شرط مسلم. ابن عباس narrates, or he says, عفواً, ابن عباس says, إذا خافت الحامل على نفسها والمرضع على ولدها في رمضان يفطران ويطعمان مكان كل يوم مسكينا ولا يقضيان صوما. هذا هو الرأي. If they fear for themselves or their babies, they break their fast and they feed. But again, يا إخوة, I would advise you to apply this only to that certain condition, certain case. But women who get pregnant one time, two times, لا, make up the days. جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والحمد لله رب العالمين.